Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Peter began to say to Jesus, "We have given up everything and followed you." And Jesus said, "Amen, I say to you, there's no one who has given up house or brothers or sisters or mother or father or children or lands for my sake and for the sake of the gospel who will not receive 100 times more now in this present age. Houses and brothers and sisters and mothers and children and lands with persecutions and eternal life in the age to come. But many that are first will be last, and the last will be first." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
The title of our reflection today is Reward and Reversal. Jesus promised his disciples that they will receive reward, eternal life in heaven, and the reversal or punishment in hell. Reward is given to us as something good because of the good we have done. And of course, the reversal is the reverse. We suffer because of something bad we have done. Reward and punishment is not the arbitrary decision of God out of favoritism, because God does not play favorites. Or punishment, it does not come from God's vengeance, because God is just. We receive reward or punishment not because of the authoritarian rule of God, favoritism, and vengeance, but because it is the consequence of our choice, of the exercise of our freedom. If you choose bad, the consequence is punishment. If you choose good, the consequence is reward. So do not blame God if you receive reward or punishment. Actually, it's the consequence of your personal choice in life. Because God is just. He does not play favorite or take vengeance. He is just. And part of his justice is to give reward, meaning respect, acknowledge the good the person has done, or punish, because he's also good, for the things left undone, good things left undone, or bad things done. So this is the consequence. You receive the reward or receive the punishment. The second point is, the reward in this world, when you receive the reward in this world, you will never receive it in the life to come. Amen, amen, I say to you, they have already received the reward in this world. They receive the reward here, then there's no reward in heaven. You remember the teachings of Jesus on prayer and fasting and almsgiving. Amen, amen, I say to you, they have already received the reward. So if you receive your reward here on earth for the good things you've done from God, the reward from, you will not be able to receive them the next life. However, if you receive some punishment wholeheartedly out of penance or contrition, your punishment, which should supposed to be eternal in the life to come, will be transmuted into a temporary punishment. So no longer eternal punishment because you have suffered here, no longer eternal punishment in the life to come, but temporary. Of course, we know that the eternal punishment is in hell and temporary punishment is suffered in purgatory. So if you do not suffer for your sins here, you do not pay, you do not restore retribution, so to say, then your punishment will be transmuted as eternal punishment in the life to come. That's the promise of Jesus. That's why for Catholics, we suffer because we are sorry for our sins, for our penance. We also suffer for the sins of the world. So the reward here, when received, has no merit in heaven, life to come. The punishment when received here, when suffered, voluntarily, paid, restored, etc., then the eternal punishment here supposed to be becomes the temporary punishment in the life to come. So gani, ambal sa mga santos, ang imo nga mga ginasa, mga sakripisyo diri sa duta, dako-dako ang iya talos dito sa pihak, sa pinak sa kabuhi. Example, magbulig ka lang sa imol. Most especially when you give up something para ma-practice mong generosity and kindness. Ang iya promise, pila kagatos ka pilo sa pihak ng kinabuhi, ang bal ni Jesus. Sa gamay nga bagay diri, ang iya equivalent dito, gatos-gatos kapilo. Kani hindi kita magkaimot. Of course, we do things because we love our neighbor. You love your wife, your children. But most especially, we do things because we know the consequence of it is eternal reward in heaven. And we avoid sa mga bagay nga malain, kaya balaan natin ang consequence is eternal separation from God in the life to come. So, amuning hambal ni Jesus, may reward diri, kang may reward man dito. Kung ubuson mong imo reward, wala ka na dito. May mga consolations ka diri, pero hindi mo pag-ubusan. May punishment diri, ubuson mo na diri yung punishment mo, para wala ka na to punishment. To baliskad naman siya. Ubuson mo di. Ang reward di mo pag-ubuson, kay dito pa. Pero ang punishment, ubuson mo bayad di. Para nga, wala ka na sa balayran sa pihak na kinabuhi. Amen. This we ask, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.